it's about people are let's say suffering from this pandemic. So let's say that what can we do to maintain ourselves? Mm-hmm. What Dhamma or what teachings that we can? So let's ask with Venerable Ngofuang that, okay, you are a meditation teacher, you teach a devotee. So like, what kind of Dhamma should we have or make ourselves to maintain with this situation?
The capacity of human being is to be enlightened. We enlighten through the good situation and we enlighten through the bad situation. And in Buddhism, the Four Noble Truths is from the bad situation. And we can observe positively the situation right now of the whole world suffering in COVID-19. We can see it as the opportunity rather than the disaster for us to grow up spiritual development, for us to see the suffering as the dukkha satya first.
Dukkha satya.
At the moment there is no awareness, at that moment the disaster will come sooner or later. So the whole body of this planet now under suffering, these are outcome compulsory by the non-awareness of collective karma, no awareness of human action. You know, the word of human can be lies, but the action happen always prove the truth. So now we can see the truth, something have done before, so this outcome happening like suffering collectively, the whole human beings. So I think the main reason here is how much awareness of human action. Whenever the awareness reach us area, we'll be safe. Without the awareness, we'll be the suffering appear sooner or later. Therefore, satipatthana or mindfulness practice is a very useful tool for us. For example, here, the kaya nubasana, body. If I sit here, I am not aware of my body, I will sit in such a very ugly posture. Then if I aware of that, at the moment I am aware of that, will be changed. So the awareness will be the best remedy for any kinds of, problems, disease, even the collective disaster of human facing now.